What is good, guys? We are back. We are gonna hop on the ladder. We are ready. I haven't tested my team, but I have a good feeling about this team that I just built. Yeah, you can see that I'm using some mons every like game. Nihiligo is like something I've used a lot lately, and also Landers is on almost every team. It's like the primal Groudon of OU, but it's just needed to check a lot of stuff, I feel like. And that's that like important ground immunity that I needed for this team. Alone Marowak is really cool with Rockhead to break Star with Flab. It's so pokey. I'm used it the other day, so I wanted to build around that. I have Shifkey and Magearna. The Ferrothorn is gonna be annoying to kill, but I have HP Fire and Nihiligo. Usually I had HP Fire and Nihiligo to kill it, but he has rain, so that's gonna be annoying. I'm gonna check this guy's rank. We also have yeah, we have the Marowak to kill the Ferrothorn this time, and we also have Orisfeon on Magearna to hit it for some damage. I have a Timid Magearna because I wanted to outspeed stuff after a shift key. Let me just check this guy's rank. I'm not trying to get outplayed again. Okay, okay, not the best rank. So he's gonna leave with Pelipper, Ferrothorn, or Greninja, or Landorus, so lots of options. Magearna does well versus most of his team, so I'm gonna leave it Magearna. As we have T-Bolt on this, which I didn't even mention yet, this is Electrium Z Magearna to kill Toxapex, because yeah, Toxapex is really annoying. Among Us is on this team to check Pheromosa. I just want to go for a T-Bolt because I don't think he's gonna expect. Okay, never mind, he scouted for it. Good play, good play. I thought he would just go for like, actually yeah, I forgot that Magearna runs Volt Switch all the time if it's AV, so it was so obvious. If I RS feared that, it would have been amazing. Oh yeah, we're just gonna RS fear now. That actually did a good chunk. Thankfully he doesn't go for Leech Seed, which is amazing. Oh, maybe I should make this Focus Blast, but I'd rather have Orisfear 100% accurate. Yeah, so we already made a, I don't want to say misplay turn 1, but we could have played it better turn 1. Because there's no way he sacks his rain so early. And yeah, he's gonna leech it now. This is gonna be annoying. Oh, I don't have hazard control on this team, RIP. Because yeah, I forgot. Like this team, I made some changes. I had a Latios at first, but I was so weak to some, to Volcarona, which is why I added Nihiligo. I was also weak to Sadwai. We just go hard Marowak. Yeah, I basically have to wish path to get my Marowak back healthy. If I ever, if I ever let it get low with hazards and stuff, like if rocks are up, or maybe I have to change. I have to think what I can change. Oh yeah, I had a Scarf for Ramosa at first over Nihiligo Rapid Spin. And at some point I had a Latios, like I already mentioned. I want a Shadow Ball here because it should, I don't know if it kills, but I don't think he's sacking this. I kind of want an SD because he could protect, but that's not the play to make. Yeah, this guy's bad. I should have SD'd. I feel like the Landorus was obvious, which is why I didn't SD. Landorus slash Pelipper slash Greninja. I'm just going to Shadow Ball and get some damage on his Landorus, which does absolutely nothing because he seems to be defensive. And this is probably his rocker, unless he's double hazard on the Pharaoh. So he's gonna hazard state me now. This is gonna be a pain to deal with. Let's go to Alamomola. Yeah, I need hazard control on this team. I'm gonna knock off here, predicting his Ferrothorn. The Alamomola is on the team to check stuff like Metagross. Also, just to patch bushes around. At first, I had it Spidef to check Greninja, and then I was like, I need a fifth dev one because I'm so weak to Metagross. So at least we get rid of the recovery. We can try to burn this now, or we can just go, we can wish and then we can go into Marowak. So wish is basically my only way to avoid, like, avoid hazard damage. I mean, I will take hazard damage, but I will heal back. But so yeah, we already realized the weakness of this team. I thought this team was like, I didn't want to say flawless, but I thought this team was really good. Not having hazard control and you face hazard stake in the first game, I don't want to complain, but that's nice that we get to see the weakness in the first game, not later on. So I can think about what I could change. I could put a Latios over something and then make... Because Latios makes me less weak too. I need something that checks that why basically. If I get rid of Nihiligo, I have to run something else to check that why. I'ma just spam Shadow Bone. This Pelipper is gonna take a lot. Get a crit, which is nice. That looks to be super defensive. Let me actually calc that. Mimiricus, 494 attack. I think it's like 116. Yeah, and the Pelipper took only 75 from a crit. Let's say plus one, because crits do 1.5 damage, right? So it's like plus one. Shadowmoon is 66 to 78. Wait, the standard Pelipper spread doesn't run any speed. But let's say it's max defense, he would take 75. So I either get absolute max or he's running speed. I don't think I can afford to send my Marowak. This is a tough decision. Because if I switch, I take hazard damage. I think I have to bank on this Marowak being fast, which is not the case. He actually is running some speed on his Pelipper, so I'm actually lucky that he predicted me to switch there. If he scored it there, I was in a really bad position. So I basically got... I don't want to say I got played there, but... I don't know why I didn't go for the water move. I know he predicted me to switch into a Mungus slash Almola, but with the health up, I did feel like it was a fine play for him just to scald. Or Hurricane. And now something's gonna take a huge hit. This puts me in a good position. We can weaken his Landris. But yeah, this is gonna be tough. I might have to pause it after this game and think about potential changes. I think he's forced to Earthquake here because we get the minus defense. Look, all this hazard damage. So yeah, we can go for a Wish here. This has U-turn, so I guess we can protect and then Wish. Never mind! That was a misplay by me again. I had no reason not to Wish. He didn't know yet if my Marowak has Rocket, he doesn't know that yet, so... I could have easily, gone into Marowak on the Tapu Koko if I had a Wish in the air. And now he can go on a Pharaoh Sword. And I have Stunspore on this, which is a bit questionable in the meta with Tapu Fini running around, but I wanted to support Marowak so I can outspeed more things. But yeah, he's just gonna U-turn into Pharaoh Sword, there's not much I can do. I mean, what does Ferrothorn even do to me? I feel like I can just Giga Drain. I mean, I could have gone to my Landers there to get some helmet, but that would have given him a free Greninja. Not being able to get rid of... Oh, why did he go to Greninja? This guy actually choked, in my opinion. What? I guess he predicted... What? Did he predict HP Fire? But the rain was up. I don't understand. I'm gonna just Giga Drain again, then hopefully it doesn't freeze me. I'm really spadef on this, so I can eat this up. Phew, we get rid of one big threat, but Amoongus is almost dead, which is bad. Because Amoongus is my Tapu Koko answer, basically. Let me think. I mean... I could run, like, HP Rock for most over the Nihiligo, which also checks out why in Volcarona. And gives me a rapid spin, but... That's not reliable. Nihiligo can at least switch into Zardwai once or twice. If I run Firmoza over that, I'm forced to sack every time Zard comes out. Latios is not that good in this meta, but... What I like about Latios is... the Giga Vault Havoc set to Luan, Celesteela, and... Skarmory, stuff like that. And also that gets Defog. So I think he's gonna U-turn here. I'm gonna go to my Landers, get some helmet on his. He could also go for HP Ice, which I didn't think about. But yeah, I'm gonna just HP Ice on my on my own here. Yeah, since I run minus speed on my landers, and maybe I should change that. Maybe I should start running like 40 speed degrees or 50 on my landers. But I'd usually like the slow U-turn. But yeah, this is not Auras anymore. Landers start run HPIs today, these days. He's gonna outspeed. I don't know. I don't think he outspeeds me. I mean, Landris is. All Landris does at this point is being fodder, so I'm gonna get my rocks up at least. As he overpredicts, there's always Pelipper dies to rocks now. I don't know what this guy is doing with his overprediction play, but it's really costed him. I can just sack this here and then. I don't really have anything to come in afterwards besides the Nihiligo. And then I'm forced to go for HP5, predicting the Ferrothorn. But he can just sack his Pelipper. But yeah, I think that's the play I have to make. I cannot switch hard into this. Wait. My Amoonguss is not regenerated. This shit always happens. Oh my god. I mean, my Amoonguss was really low anyway, but this is annoying. Why is this all... Why do I not pay attention? My Alamomola is regenerated. Majuna is so hard. Yeah, I'm forced into Nihiligo. Not being regenerated sucks because I could come in on Ferrothorn otherwise, potentially. But yeah, I feel like I have to HP fire here. If he stays in, he's just a lord. But yeah, the Ferrothorn was so obvious there. And now he can sack his Pelipper if he wants to. But I think I'm forced to stay in, basically. I don't know why he protected there. He wasted his last turn of rain, which was not a good play. Get a beast boost. Actually, never mind. He has three more turns. Because he has the terrain. Not the terrain. What am I talking? He has the damp rock. So now I can either sack my Amoonguss. The thing is with this Nihiligo, I can... If I switch out and come back in, I have no more switch-ins to health afterwards. And I have to predict his between his Mawile and him staying in, so I feel like I just want to get damage off here. Yeah, I think I would just want to get damage, which... Oh, this is a nothing, what? That did... What? Is this a Solvice type of Koko? Okay, I made the wrong play then. Basically just lose this. I mean, I can go into Merwick and bluff that I have Rockhead, because I didn't reveal that yet. I bluff that I have Lightning Rod. And I can go for Shadowbone here. But if he went for Thunder there... So by forcing his type of Koko out, he has to take rocks, which is amazing. And with the rain being gone, nah, maybe I can win this if I dodge his Thunder. I mean, there's no point in keeping Marowak after Hazard dies to Capu Koko and to everything. He's just gonna Sucker Punch here, I assume. I have to hope basically for a choke. This was such a rough matchup because I didn't have Hazard control. Other than that, if I had Hazard control and I had Regenerator on my Amoonguss, and I didn't make that one misplay where I protected, I would have been in a good position. Yeah, that was a huge misplay, the turn where I protected. Good lord. So if I don't get this burn, I can click X. It's all. Wait, we outspeed? I didn't know that. Oh, amazing, get the burn. We end this. Mikal, Alamomola versus... I mean, I think I still lose to the Koko. Mega Mawile. Left is 54. Wait, I have way more defense on my Alamomola. Okay, Playref doesn't kill. I'm gonna go for Wish. I see. Oh, I didn't think about Thunder Punch. I'm actually bad. What am I doing? I mean, this is fine. This is fine. I can go into my journal here. I don't know why I got so mad. Like, I can go in my journal. I'm gonna get the wish path. I can shift gear up. Outspeed is Tapu Koko. Thankfully, no crit. We get the wish back. And I'm gonna just go for the Z move here, Gigavolt Havoc. And I'm gonna probably win this with my Magearna. Amazing. We get the special attack boost. We should also outspeed him, and Fleshkin should kill him. And even if we don't outspeed him, we should live one hit, right? Okay, amazing. We lucked out in this. The burn versus the Mauler was nice. I mean, I don't even know if I needed the burn, because I had completely forgot that I had Magearna in the back. But yeah, I think I needed the burn. So 60 minutes, what a long first game. I really don't know what to change for highlight control. So I paused it for a bit, and I think I'm just gonna leave the team how it is for now. I was thinking about like Scarf Latios over Nihiligo, which would checks out why, but I would have to run like, it also would kind of check Volcarona, because they don't really run Bug Buzz these days. But I was like, there's the odds that we will face hazard stacking again, it's like they're not that high, so I was like, it's fine. Let's just go with the same team again. But yeah, I wouldn't recommend using this team like that much. It's not bad, but okay, this guy's 1800, but he doesn't have the best win-loss ratio. But we can get points if we beat this guy. Okay, okay. So wait, he's 76 GXE. Okay, okay. So he has a Mega Scizor, he has a Gengar, and Z-move Dragonite probably. Potential Scarf Gengar, probably Rocks Clefable or Rocks Nidoking. Now Rocks Clefable makes more sense. So I want to leave off with Nihiligo here, as we get that completely wrong, as it is with Nidoking. So I'm forced into Amoongus here. Yeah, Amoongus was a good lead. I don't know why I didn't lead with Amoongus. Amoongus basically got a spore off with everything besides Dragonite. So we eat that up, and now we can just go for Spore, because he doesn't have Misty Terrain. He also doesn't have a Grass type or anything like that. So Amoongus is actually mating this matchup. Stun Sporing there would have also been a nice option. But now I just want to go into my Marowak, honestly. I kind of want to Stun Spore predicting a double, but I feel like going Marowak is an option. Double, oh, Stun Sporing there would have been amazing if it hit. But yeah, I'm just gonna go back. As he might Ice Beam this time. He just Earth Powers. Okay, now we cannot put him to sleep, but we can attempt to hit a Stun Spore. We missed this dude. Okay, we hit, amazing. So we can basically fish for Paras. He might Ice Beam here, predicting my Landorus. Oh my god, Alamomola. If you off pause, it's gonna do 5 bajillion. Yeah, rip, rip, rip. I'm gonna go Landorus here, because there's no way you Ice Beam this specific turn. Okay, perfect. And now we can go for a U-turn, I think. U-turn seems like the play to make. If he would have stayed in, I would have gone into something that resists Ice Beam. And if he will steady his pressure, but his helmet, so U-turn there was not optimal, I guess. So it's probably Defog Zapdos. What I can do is I can bring my Marowak here and I can click Flare Blitz. Cause he doesn't know, like he doesn't know yet that I don't have Lightning Rod, so there's no way he goes for Electric Move here. He doesn't have a good switch in besides, no, he doesn't have good switch ins to this. Like Dragonite switched into Flare Blitz, but I could also go for Shadowbone here. So I like this position I'm in. As he sacks off his Nidoking. Now he knows that I'm Rockhead, but this is fine with me. He goes into Dragonite. I'm gonna Shadowbone to break his multi-scale. Do I need Landorus for anything? Landorus doesn't do much this game, so let's just bring it in to get the Intimidate off. If he wastes his Z-move, that's absolutely fine. I also could have gone Heart and Heligo. I don't know why Drain Dance it again. I want to switch out because he's going to go for Z-move here. Heligo is nice to kill Zapdos. So I wanted to go Magearna here on the Z-move. So he predicted that correctly. This is going to do like 80. Yeah, 74. Now we're just going to go back into Landorus, get another Intimidate off. He might even Earthquake here. Yeah, amazing. And now we can just go for HPI since he doesn't have a Z-move anymore. This puts us in a decent position. And this doesn't even kill. And he dies to Helmet now, so I can get my rocks up here. So he goes for Fly. Is there a point in switching out? Like, Landorus doesn't do much. What did he... I don't know why he said that. I can go into Alamomola here to keep this, but... I don't think there's a point in doing that. What is Magearna doing this game? Magearna is nice to kill the Clefable, so I want to keep it. I mean, I have some options to kill a Clef. Yeah, I'm gonna go into Alamomola. I should be able to take one. It's gonna do like 80. Oh, okay, a dodge. Rip. I'll just Scald here. I'm a knockoff. Okay, this was a lucky dodge, but I don't think that would have killed. One and two, I don't think I need my Alamomola. So he's probably gonna defog here. I'm gonna just go into Nihiligo though. There's no. Like, I wanna knock off really badly, but there's no point in making that play. Defog was super obvious there. I can just Power Jam. Like, he's gonna go Scissor, but I don't really care. I can HP Fire, yeah. I don't have to make this play, but I wanna HP Fire so badly. Call me, yeah. Phew, thankfully we get that correct. Now we can spam. Sludge Wave, and he just forfeits. Okay, amazing. So that went well, and we are in the 1598. So yeah, this guy was really high, so we got some points from him. Let's just look for another game. Hopefully we don't fight Hazard Stack. But yeah, I was really glad how the second game went. The biggest threat was like the Nidoking, so... we get a threatening team with a Zard. Double ground type, I faced that yesterday. Let me see. Okay, he also doesn't have the best GXE, but that doesn't always mean much. So, let me think here. Formosa is probably Scarf or Z-move. Magearna could be as always, because he's kind of weak to Greninja. I feel like he's gonna leave with Landorus or Zard. So this guy knows my videos. This is gonna be even harder to beat him, I feel like. Yeah, I wanna lead off with Alamomola here, breaking Landorus. Or Tapu Fini. I can go for knockoff on this. Too bad I don't have Mirror Code, as a subscriber suggested, to kill Tapu Fini. Mirror Code Alamomola would have been nice, maybe. Goes to Zard, makes a good play. So we will go hard into Nihiligo here. Zard is a big threat. We should be take like 34 from a Solar Beam. Oh my god, come on! I'm gonna go for HP Fire here. Predicting his Magearna. This is gonna do a lot in the sun. Actually, that did nothing. So you can Voltage G to gain momentum into Zard. Like, the thing is, if I go to Landris and he Volt Switches, that's, I'm in a good position. But I'm gonna go into Among Us, because if he Flurkens and then go and I go Landris, I'm just in a... Okay, this guy doubled, so he's stunted. Yeah, like, critting my Nihiligo didn't make this easier at all. The only thing I have going for me is that the sun only lasts 2 more turns. Don't burn me, phew, and now I can protect on the last turn. I mean, he's probably gonna switch out. Okay, he didn't switch, phew. Now I can go for a wish, or... Yeah, I wanna go for a wish here. Damn, this start is such a threat. I have to somehow wish my Nihiligo up. As he goes Chapofini. If he's not Surf, I can go into my Nihiligo here. But I'd rather knock this off. Going to Nihiligo here is like so tempting. I want to do this play so badly. But if he has a water move and I die, I mean, I can call, but Nihiligo versus Tapofini. Let's say he's, if he's Hydro Pump. I mean, if he's Hydro Pump offensive, I die, but he has to be defog on this team. Surf does 41 to 49. Yeah, I died to Surf, so yeah, I'm gonna just make the knockoff play. So we got rid on... We can see his Assault Vest, okay, I was about to say. We can see now if he's of Assault Vest or if he's Z-move. But he's probably Z-move, one of these three. So this is tough. I have to calculate how much Flurkin does for myself as Majuna. Because if I can live a Flurkin, I'm gonna stay and go for Wish for sure. I don't want him doubling the Zara though. I need rocks up for the Zara. The Zara is gonna fucking crush me. I have like no speed death on this. 132. But I have like a lot of HP. Flurkin does 92 max, so I can afford to go for a wish here. Okay, good. And Flash can probably still kill this Nihiligo even though he's at minus 2, right? Flash can at minus 2 actually doesn't kill Nihiligo. Does 32 to 38. So I can go Nihiligo here. Which is amazing. Zard is such a big pain to deal with. I mean, he's gonna go... If he goes Garchomp, do I lose anything? Like, I don't think there's a way he's staying in here. Garchomp is so obvious. I wanna go Landris here. Like, there's no way you sack your Zard, dude. Come on, like, if you sack your Zard... Yeah, okay. I don't know why he went into Tapofini, but thought he would go into Chomp. Do I need health on this? Health on this is nice, yeah. I'm definitely not staying in here. I'm not going to Hilligo because I don't want him doubling into Zard. Yeah, I should have gone into Among Us, but I thought Among Us was so obvious. Let's just go for Power Gem here. It's probably, yeah, I thought he would go into Chomp eventually. So this really didn't work out as planned. Now he's gonna get Rocks Up, but the thing is, nah, if he gets Rocks Up, I get my Rocks Up and he's forced to defog. Hopefully this is not a Chain Chomp special with Draco Meteor, but that would be horrible. I mean, the sun ends next turn, so he cannot double the Zard here, which is something. He gets a 5 and crit. Ouch. No burn, and I can get my rocks here, which forces him to defog. Dang. So, I can U-turn here. Now, I can rocks again. Watch this play. I can rocks again, predict him to defog. Okay, this doesn't really accomplish anything, because We can U-turn here. I think Nature's Madness is... Now we can go into... We can go Majorna and set up a shift gear here. I feel like that's a good play. Because even if he gets rid of the rocks, Zod should die, dude. Zod should die to a fucking... My flash can here in case he goes Landorus. I think he's gonna... He's gonna Nature's Madness here, so maybe I should T-Bolt. But I don't want him going Landorus. Let me call up 1 second. Jenna versus Tapu. I'm timid. Oh, flesh can. Why does it do so little? Because I'm minus two. Yeah, I'm T-bolting here. Flesh can doesn't do enough. So he makes the Zod Y play. I don't agree with that play, but this worked out amazingly. Perfectly. Things I have to T-build again, so he might just switch out into... He might just switch out here. Like, Flash Cannon doesn't kill Zod Y, there's no way. So I'm forced to T-build again, he can go into Landorus here, but... That's fine, like, I weakened his Zard. Thunderbolt did 59 to 70. Yeah, I did 60. So I got minimum damage. Oh, he's running HP. Flash can doesn't kill. Yeah, I'm just T-bolting again. Like, you can go to Landorus if you wanna. I'm not playing around with a Zod Y. It's way too big of a threat. Yeah, way too much of a threat to just overpredict like that. I wish I had like a mid-ground player that would hit the Landorus and the Zard. But I really don't have a mid-ground player. Like, he should just go to Landorus or to his own Majorna here. Wait, but his own Majorna's already weakened. Yeah, I guess it's Landorus then. So he goes to his own Majorna, which I got a crit on. I don't know if that matters. I feel like that didn't really matter. And I can just Flash Cannon here, and I get a Soul Heart boost. So everything's going well now. This is amazing. The Soul Heart boost is nice. Look at this Majorna, plus 2 speed, plus 1 attack, plus 1 special attack, and then the evasion too. So I'm pretty sure Landorus lives the hit. He said, I think that's game. I don't have Aura Sphere, so I cannot kill your Landorus. I wish I had Z Steel move. But yeah, I can Kalk too. I can Kalk Landorus Jarion. He didn't set up rocks with his Chomper. I think his Chomper might be Scarf. So I feel like this is defensive Lander. Flash Cannon doesn't do enough. Yeah, I'm definitely not staying in here. Wait, how much does Earthquake do from defensive Lander? Earthquake doesn't kill me. Okay, I'm staying in then. Yes, that kills. Oh my god. He's offensive Landorus. Yeah, I shouldn't have stayed in then, but now I get a free Nihiligo here, basically. I can click Sludge Wave. Let me just calc how much... Man, I really want to sweep up Majorna. Nihiligo should kill us with Sludge Wave, right? 23, yeah. I mean, the Nihiligo being in means Zod Y cannot come in and revenge me. Like, Zod Y cannot come in, which basically is the reason I'm not sending out my Alamomola or my Amoongus. But yeah, he's probably gonna go to Chompy here. I don't have HPI, so there's no point in clicking anything other than Sludge Wave. Man, I really wish my Majorna could sweep. But I feel like this team... This team doesn't have the best ways to break toxic picks. I mean, I have knockoff on my Alma Mola for toxic packs, and Marowak is gonna do a lot with Shadowbone, and I can PP start up between Alma Mola and Amoongus, but if they have Heather stack, I cannot switch around like that. So I feel like ZT Ball is the correct choice on this team. So I'm really disappointed that my Majorna didn't get the sweep there. I didn't think he would be running attack on his Landorus, because looking at his team, like, he's so weak to stuff like Zardex, which is not common. Okay, he has a type of Fini, but that's not a good answer anyway. Like, Zardex is not common, but what else? Yeah, Marowak is kind of common. Not that common, but something you kind of have to prepare for. What are the physical attackers that I cannot think of for some reason that beat Landorus in this meta? That Landorus checks is what I meant. Like, there's so many things that Landorus checks. Physical Pheromosa, obviously, but Pheromosa run Ice Beam all the time. I really cannot think of anything. There's Tapu Bulu that you check. I mean, he has a Majorna, but that's gonna get worn down as he's thinking really hard about his plays. He makes the Fini play. I don't agree with this play. I don't know why he went Fini when he had a Garchomp. Like, he can just go to Garchomp now. I'm not gonna overpredict. This is fine with me. I guess he was predicting HPIs. I can understand. Yeah, he was predicting HPIs there, I feel like. Pretty sure he did that. You can tell me in the comments. Like, he can go to Garchomp. It's completely fine with me. I think he's Scarf Chomp. Like, I'll have my Landorus to switch in on this Chomp. I guess he can double switch into Zard on my Landorus, but. Yeah, okay, he just decides to sack his Fini. I got a beast boost with my Nihiligo. And he's gonna bring in his Chomper here. Or his Scarforamosa. He brings in his Chomper and. Yeah, I'm just. Actually, Landorus is low. Huh. Do I need Landorus for anything? I'ma go Landorus, but he's gonna go for Dragon Move and kill me probably. He makes a double into Zard. Yeah, that's also what I was talking about. He could make that play, but that's completely fine. Like, just gonna U-turn here in case he roosts. He hits his Fire Blast, which is nice for him. I don't want to win by hexing. I want to calc how much. I don't have HPIs on the Helio. I would click it if I had it here, maybe. Marowak should probably take a hit. But yeah, this is rough. Marowak Alola versus Charizard Y. I mean, he made a nice play there, but I don't think I was in a position to predict anything in that specific turn. I need my Dehiligo. But yeah, Shadowboning should be fine here. He's probably gonna sack his Landorus. And then he's gonna bring his Garchomp back. Or he can also attack me to weaken me. Damn, I hope you can win this game, because otherwise. We didn't really make much progress this episode. I mean, we made some progress because the last guy gave us a lot of points. So, but winning this would push us into the 1600s, which is definitely not high at all, but it is something. Like, the last episodes we have just been chilling on the lower ladder, and 1600s is basically where it starts to get serious, I feel like. So I'm gonna have to really, like, put a lot of thought into the next teams I build, or really, or ask really good players for teams. Because I'm not trying to get crushed. I mean, good teams to ladder. There's a difference between teams that work on the ladder and teams that work in the tournament. Okay, he decides to suck off his Pheromosa, because I guess it wasn't doing. Yeah, Pheromosa wasn't doing much with Marowak and Amoongus being around, and now you can go Garchomp or Lando. I can choose, like, if he doubles here again into Zard, I guess he can just U-turn into Zard if he has that. I feel like Amoongus is the play here. As that does a shit ton, so he's probably off play. Do I sack this? Yeah, I sack my Among Us here. And then I come in there with my... God, why is this game so close? I could have played better. If I switched out my Midjourney on the earthquake, I would have been in such a good position. How much does that way take from Scald? I feel like I choked this away by not switching my Midjourney out. Like, if he goes Garchomp here, I'm in a super bad position, but I don't think I can afford to double here. There's no way I can afford to double in this position. Like, I want to double so badly, predicting his Chomper here. Like, he can still save this Landorus, because Landorus outspeeds Armamola and Marowak, so it has value for him, and it's also a fodder for later. Yeah, this is such a bad... Like, if I had HP Ice here, I would just click it and win, but I have HP 5, sadly. But if I'm gonna make this HP Ice... Like, HP 5 came in clutch in the second game, killing the Scissor. Like... There's gonna be some scenario where I wish I had HP Fire when I make it HP Ice, I already know. This is always how it works. I change on one set, and the next game I face something that I'm... That I am weak to now because I changed my set. Just go to Chomp, dude. Like, I'm forced to Sludge Wave, kind of. I mean, I guess it's 50-50s. Okay, he stays in. Thankfully, I didn't make the double there. I was so close to making the double, and now he can just... I think I kind of lose. I have to keep this. It's not over, dude. Like, did he say GG as in... If I sack my Nihiligo... If I sack my Nihiligo... If I sack my Nihiligo, I can lose to his Zard. If I set Marowak here, I assume he goes for Outrage here, but let me calc. Alamomola versus Garchomp. I hope he goes for Earthquake and I can avoid a 2K. Amazing, amazing. Go for Wish here, and I feel like going Marowak is the right play all the time here, because it should get me a kill. Yeah, I think I have it now, but oh my god, that was close. Okay, okay, it's not over yet, but Shadowbone should kill us. Shadowbun should get a kill here. Shouldn't have sent my Midjourney, is what I'm gonna tell him. Yeah, sacking Midjourney was so huge, but I was like... getting so excited that I could 3-way my Midjourney. Like, looking at his team, I thought it would be defensive. I've probably already mentioned that. Yeah, going... I feel like going Marowak, that was the correct play. Because if I go Nihiligo... Okay, to deal with Stolen SD. If I went into the helical there, yeah, that kills. We should win now. Yeah, we win. So when the helical there, it was still in bad position because he could have gone the guard jump. And if he clicked outrage on my Alma Mola, I might have lost. As I just set my Marowak here. Yeah, that makes sense. Stall is a bitch to deal with. Yeah, I'm just playing the safe. He has to be Scarf Jump, right? He's already SD on Lando. Like, I know it's Lando's offensive, and the way he played this has to be Scarf. Like, I'm not taking any risks here. I'm not trying to get critted or anything. Okay, I'm out of range for a crit, so I can go for Scald. But I'm just playing this super safe, like... I'm really not trying to choke this away, like, this was... Whew. That way is still a big threat, even though I have an early goal. If you had a doggy, it would have been over. I mean, yeah, I also had Marowak to check it, because I could keep my Marowak healthy, which was... Thank the Lord I could keep my Marowak healthy. I think he's running Jolly on his side because when I... Pretty sure there's like 45 to chance. Yeah, run Adder then. Yeah, I just have to get his burn here and it's over, like... Okay, yeah, that's the burn. And yeah, I can just click Skull now, I don't have to unnecessary. Yeah, GG, man. Almost got me with the Zard with the double earlier. Whew. Thank you guys so much for watching, super long episode. We are 1620s, we can check our rank here. As we have an 81.8 GXE, which is not super good, but it's okay. It's gonna go up higher if we can keep winning, but it's gonna get tough now. Oh my Lord, I'm glad that we went positive in this episode though. The first game was rough, the first game, I feel like we should have lost the first game. That was rough. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you with another shot on live or with some SBL coverage next. We will see. And I'm Doc Rich, I'm signing out. Peace.